I would, being able to estimate, so not finding the exact answer, but estimating the sums and differences of fractions, why would that be helpful to you? Yes, Kaylee.
It might give you an idea of what the answer could be so that you don't have to have the exact answer.
Perfect. And that's good when we want to check our work, or if you want to just see kind of where. Oh, you can't see me?
I can't see me.
It's too zoomed in.
All right, so we're gonna continue to use equivalent fractions to be able to do this. So here's an example. We have Lucita and Alexis, and they went scuba diving for 7 1/3 hours. So what number, two numbers, is 7 1/3 hours between? Who can tell me? What two numbers is 7 1/3 between? Where would I find it on a number line? Dominic?
7 and 8.
7 and 8. Is it closer to 7 or 8?
7. 7,
because it's 1/3. So it would be like right here. The next day they went scuba diving for 4 2/3 hours. What two numbers would 4 2/3 go between? Cool.
4 and 5.
4 and 5.
Closer
so it's always going
to
be this number and then the next number that will come on the number line. And it is closer to 5 because it's 2/3. So we are going, they say about how many hours did they spend scuba diving all together? So about is my clue that they do not want the exact answer, they want the estimate. Kaylee.
So would you add the two whole numbers?
Good. So this is kind of different because these are mixed numbers. These are where we have a whole number plus a fraction. So you can do either way. You can add the whole numbers first and then add the fractions, or you can add the fractions and then the whole numbers. But because we're estimating, we are going to kind of, we're going to make them whole numbers, okay? Because we're estimating. And just like we did here, we said 7 1/3, well, that's closer to 7. So that's why I'm going to put 7 here. And then 4 2/3, well, that's closer to 5. So instead of 7 1/3 plus 4 2/3, I'm going to do 7 plus 5.
Are you estimating on fractions?
We are.
On blue box?
I don't think there is. So our answer is about, what is 7 plus 5?
I know.
Emily.
No.
12. All right. So it is about, that's all right. It's about 12. So Lucita and Alexis spent about 12 hours scuba diving all together. That's a long time. I'm afraid of
the gas tank.
The oxygen tank, it must hold that much long, you know.
That's a half of a day.
But I'm afraid of the ocean, so I can't do this. Here is our next example. 1 sea anemone. And I got to meet these fellas. Sea anemones. They're pretty cool. It's 3 1/4 feet across. While a second sea anemone is 5 3/4 feet across. About, so again we have that about, how much longer across is the second sea anemone? So this is cluing me in to do subtraction and estimating. So I need to think about 5 3/4, or first, yeah, okay. So what two numbers is 5 3/4 between? My first number is gonna be this one. What do you think, Asia?
5 and 6.
Is 3/4 making it closer to 5 or 6, Noah?
6. 6.
So that one's about 6. 3 1/4. Vincent, what two numbers is 3 1/4 between? It's always this one first. 3, and then what comes after 3? 4. And this is 1/4 right here, Gabby. So does that make it closer to 3 or 4? 1/4.
Oh,
3. 3. So there I have now 6 minus 3, which is What, Ethan? 3. So that second sea anemone is about 3 feet longer across from the first sea anemone. That's a huge sea anemone. I want to see one of those. Yes.
Discover new type of fish.
That sounds like an awesome job. All right, so now we